I'm Kento Bento.
This video was made possible by East Meet East. Find your Valentine on the number one Asian dating app in North America and around the world at eastmeeteast.com/KentoBento. So, here's a statement. Asians are cuter. Okay, wait, if that was your reaction, this video is probably not what you think. Everyone has their own opinions of what constitutes as attractive, but I'm not necessarily talking about attractiveness here. I'm talking about cuteness. Cuteness is a term describing a type of attractiveness, commonly associated with youth and appearance. It's also a scientific concept. So when I say Asians are cuter, well, they arguably are. And that's including males, not just females. Now, compared to adults, common features for infants across all ethnic groups include larger heads, flatter faces, reduction of the brow ridge, hairlessness, thinner bones, reduced muscle mass, smaller physical size, shorter arms, shorter legs, just to name a few. And of course, this is largely why people find babies cute. If they didn't have these features and proportions, they'd more so resemble miniature adults. And that's kind of creepy. Normally, as you transition from a big-headed, short-limbed baby to a longer-legged juvenile to a teenager, and finally to a fully developed adult, you would expect to lose most, if not all, of these traits. However, this isn't always the case. How many cute baby-like features you retain into adulthood largely depends on your ethnicity. And this takes us back to Asian people, specifically East Asian people, because compared to other groups, they tend to have, on average, the highest retention of childlike features. This is called neoteny, where you may still look 14 even though you're actually 30. Okay, hold up. I suppose this may be getting awkward for some of you, especially for those who have an inclination towards Asians. But it's actually not so weird. Studies have shown that, at least for men, there is a clear preference or attraction towards neotenized faces. And this is regardless of ethnicity. Men of all types were more likely to find neonate features attractive. And since Asian people were more likely to have these features, it's only natural that a high percentage of these men were also drawn to Asian people. So in many of these cases, what looked like Asian fever may have just been cuteness fever. And this is regardless of the person's actual age. According to these studies, neotenous faces were perceived as having higher sociability and femininity, whereas those low in neoteny were more intimidating. Okay, but why is this the case? Why are East Asians more neotenous? Well, about 30,000 years ago, there was a crucial juncture in the evolution of Asians. There was a gene mutation that resulted in several distinctive traits that made East Asians different from other populations. Thicker hair shafts, reduced chin protrusion, smaller breasts, changes in the morphology of ears and teeth, many of these traits making an individual look younger than they actually are. As time went on, changes in cranial morphology followed. Slightly larger heads, flatter faces, more pronounced cheekbones, reduced sexual dimorphism, which means males started to resemble females a little more. Basically, an all-round high retention of juvenile characteristics. Now, depending on your preferences, which relate to your background, your culture, your thoughts may differ on the attractiveness of the aforementioned. In Western society, the desirability of these traits is not exactly something that's encouraged when it comes to physical attraction, but in East Asia, it's pretty normal and has been the case for a very long time. In fact, it's said sexual selection likely played a major role in bringing these traits to the forefront. As mentioned previously, there is an innate attraction that males in general have towards neotenous features, regardless of culture. But in East Asian society, this is heightened. With more males selecting cute female partners, over time these traits became more and more widespread. In this sense, neoteny in Asian males is really the resulting byproduct of sexual selection. Another point to consider is that infantile features tend to trigger a nurturing response in adults. They elicit more affection, meaning that this is possibly an evolutionary adaptation to help ensure that children are taken care of by adults, and thus securing the survival of the species. In a similar sense, those who retain said traits into adulthood could have higher reproductive success. If you're wondering why non-neotenous traits exist in the first place, well, there are obvious evolutionary benefits. Larger teeth and jaws, for example, would have been needed for the constant chewing of tough, raw foods back in the day. You can see from this that neoteny is actually a condition that has affected all humans, just to varying degrees. An adult human today is a lot closer to the juvenile form of our ancestors. We're all basically mutant apes that never grew up. Okay, at this point, many of you may be wondering how the concept of Asian eyes fits into all of this. I mean, babies are supposed to have disproportionately large eyes, which would make it a neotenous trait. But then, how is this explained? I've actually done an extra video covering this specific topic, which you can check out exclusively on our Patreon page. Now, it's not just the physical characteristics that make East Asians appear cuter. It's also the way they act. If there's one country that exemplifies this the most, it would have to be Japan. Kawaii culture has long been a prominent aspect of Japanese society. The cutesy, kawaii way of talking and acting is certainly commonplace there, with many Japanese men finding this attractive. And actually, it's not just restricted to the way they look and the way they act. Kawaii cuteness is pervasive everywhere, in media, entertainment, clothing, food, toys, transport, guardrails, condoms? Okay, so the ability for adult humans to be able to act kawaii is also considered a neotenous trait. This is an example of psychological neoteny, where there is a retention of youthful attitudes and behaviors into later adulthood. While this is certainly more widespread in Japan, South Korea, parts of China, it's not strictly an East Asian phenomenon. For example, you can perhaps classify the American California Valley girl tone and behavior as a form of psychological neoteny. Now, in an evolutionary sense, this childlike trait of playfulness or prolonged immaturity can actually be a valuable developmental characteristic. It can make an individual more flexible and adaptable in life, behavioral traits that aren't nearly as beneficial in previous, more settled societies. Social roles today are dramatically less fixed. Frequent changes in our careers and personal relationships have become the norm, and perhaps the best way to deal with all this unpredictability is to embrace that youthful sense of play. It drives humans to be more curious about the world, enabling us to learn new things even as adults. By the way, I'm not saying that being straight up immature is the way to go. Of course, there's a difference between the playful adaptability as highlighted here and just plain obnoxiousness. And another thing to clear up, this topic may be a sensitive issue for certain people, as race-related topics tend to be. I know some have used neoteny to argue that Asians are inferior because they're underdeveloped and childlike. Conversely, there are others who have argued that Asians are superior to the rest of the world, given that neoteny is a characteristic of advanced evolutionary status, meaning Asians are capable of the greatest development. No, this video is not backing either of these points of view. Any differences should be cherished and appreciated in their own way. And whether you're more into Asian features or Western features or whatever, that's okay too. But if Asian is your thing and you're single, you should check out East Meet East. It's the premier Asian dating app in the US, Canada, Australia, and many other countries. You can sign up for free and browse through the 400,000 plus member database. The great thing about East Meet East is that everyone there likes Asians. So there's really no harm in at least checking it out. The link's in the description below. And remember, it's East Meet East, not meets. A lot of people get that mixed up. For those interested in the extra video I mentioned about why Asian eyes look the way they do, despite Asians being neotenous, you can check out our Patreon page. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this topic, and if you have any questions or thoughts, let us know down below. Thanks for watching, hit that like button, and of course for more Asian-y videos, don't forget to subscribe.